Nothing left to do but to dive into the truth. I don't know what to expect, except for pain. Pain is the one constant. Pretty sure something bad will happen to his sister. Speaking of this world, I'm ready. I think. How do we go from this to that? That day. This is another one of those special episodes, special openings. You know things are about to go down. Eldians. Liberio internment zone. They don't have one, they just ran through the gates. Very brave. Oh, no, do not go with him. Are these even the rules, or is this guy just a sadist? I hate being right.
お前らの先祖がおかした過ちはしっかり教育しているんだろうな。私はこの周れちゃん局の男が嘘をついていることが分かった。And there's nothing they can do about it. He's doing this for survival. この男たちにへりくだった。私は父にこの男にめまいのするような憎しみを覚え。That was awful.
Just as I expected. Pain. Like I said, this makes me really curious about Grisha and his motivations, because most of what we've seen from him has been positive. Well, that's not true. His demeanor seems somewhat reasonable. He seems somewhat level-headed. He's a doctor, cared about helping people. The one sort of questionable thing we've seen from him that I can remember is him attacking the race family, but that's sort of a weird, ambiguous thing because they were perpetuating this dynasty of lies, right? Though it's still a really brutal act, what he did. But here, he has a very strong sort of origin that you would imagine gave him very strong motivations, not unlike Erwin. Like, this is kind of how Erwin's journey got launched as well. Directly experiencing the atrocities that come from this kind of power imbalance. But where does he go from there? Does he go the Erwin route of, like, actually becoming a pure person, you know, with values and striving for higher ideals and subverting his own desires, you know? Or does he dive into that? And my guess is that he dives into it. And I say that because of where Eren is. I feel like Eren seems to be in some way, although I don't know how directly, a reflection of this experience from Grisha. That hatred for the infrastructure of the world, the intolerance for weakness, you know, the desire to be free. Oh, what is this?
我々の祖先ユミル・フリッツは大地の悪魔と契約し巨人の力を手に入れる。
Here we go. I mean, this is it, right? I'm definitely gonna have to watch this multiple times.
娘を失った直後の父親にしては饒舌だった。ご主人様の言いつけを守り、危機として己の祖先を卑下する姿は犬さながらであった。
Who knows how true that really is? I mean, I think it's clear that this is a survival mechanism for the father, for the family. The question is, how deeply does he himself believe it? How deeply does he himself agree with the state of the world? But even if he fully agrees with it, it's somewhat sympathetic. Just because the way they see the world is a life or death thing for them. To me, it seems like a coping mechanism. But I gotta watch that again, because I feel like that is gonna be endlessly important. Three seasons of very little information, and then, like, this whole mythology.
Alright,
so this lady Ymir met the Devil of All Earth and gained the power of nine titans, and then when she died, that power was split. Is it the nine thinking titans we've seen? We've had Coordinate, Armor, Colossal, Beast, Duck, whatever Ymir is, I guess? I'm sure I'm going wrong here somewhere, but just theorizing. Okay, I think I got the story he's telling, although who knows if this is even true, or if this is revisionist history for, I guess, the Marley people? This chick Ymir met the Devil of All Earth. She died, nine titans were created, which then, like, ravaged and subverted the rest of the Earth until the amazing and wonderful, and I'm sure extremely good-looking Marley people defeated them in a war, isolating them to an island where they built three walls, which I'm guessing is where everything's taking place. So we're actually on an island, which maybe explains all the seabirds. I knew it was the birds. It was the birds the whole time. But some Eldians, the descendants of Ymir, still live in this Marley land, and Jaeger is one of them. The Jaegers. I can see how that might launch Grisha's journey. If he doesn't trust this whole story, if he's resentful about the people in the place in which he lives, he might seek out what he sees as his ancestry. This world just got a whole lot bigger. That voice sounds very familiar. Yeah, his father's no fool, I don't think. This guy's at the end of his rope.
我々が直接の加害者でなくても関係ないことだ。我々にできることはこの収容区でただつつましく生きることだ。
間違っているのはどちらだろうか。私かこの世界か。おそらくは両方だろう。
This is raising so many really difficult questions, nearly impossible questions, which actually have been somewhat raised before, I think. It's just that seeing this in a more human, non-Titan context makes it easier to connect with. For me, I think one of the answers to Grisha's question is that it's definitely not his fault. I mean, he was born into this, right? But I think that your responsibility sort of starts there. You don't blame yourself for the world that you inhabit, but you take responsibility for your actions from then on. And maybe most critically in that, you don't become the evil that you hate. You recognize things for what they are, and then you do your best to do good. Or at least not to do evil. I think a more difficult question is, how much are you responsible for? Aren't you in some way responsible for the society in which you live? You know, like, by living this lie as this family, aren't they feeding into the system, and isn't that a wrong? And there's no easy answer for that. I mean, it's really tough for me to say that because I don't see anything wrong with this father trying to protect his family. Maybe the answer is something like, you do the best you can to the extent of the strength that you have, to the extent where you doing your best doesn't destroy you or destroy the people you love or people you care about. And so people who can actually take on society in that way are going to be rare. It's like a rare form of enlightened people, like Erwin, for example. And so even though this is very general and might seem like a cop-out, I feel like if you honestly do your best in that way and you push it to the limits of what you can do, that's probably sufficient. What I definitely don't think is that every single person is responsible for fixing all of society. You know, I think that actually can do more harm than good. I believe that the solution is bottom-up, starting with the individual and the individual doing his best. And so I think the biggest danger practically in this situation is that Grisha becomes warped or jaded or vengeful and feeds into the cruelty of this world. Rather than, you know, tries to be a beacon of light in it, like Erwin. Like my Lord and Savior Erwin. This is tough. I knew this was going to be a tough episode, but... But what is the world if not individuals, you know? I think just being a good person yourself is enough.
This is the proof of the Brotherhood. Brotherhood? Your sister was killed by the Maare government.
He was seeking him out, recruiting him maybe?
妹の事件の真相を知ったとき、心に誓った。本当の悪魔はどちらか教え
た。Oh god.
再び世界を正すためには、エルディアを復活させなくてはならない。マーレ政府の内通者は、フクロウと呼ばれ。
The owl. Wonder who it is.
俺たちが教わった歴史は全て、マーレに都合のいい法則。
しかしグリシャ。よくこの古語が読めたな。
なぜなら俺は始祖ユミルを信じている。
I'm sure the truth is actually somewhere in between. This is just another kind of faith. And it's a faith they're going to slip right into, because it makes them feel good. It justifies their outrage.
私はダイナ・フリッツと申します。
ダイナ・フリッツ。
王が壁の中に持ち去った始祖の巨人。これさえ手にすれば、他の巨人すべてを支配し、マーレを打ち滅ぼすことができる。
Complete annihilation, huh?
エルディアの誇りを取り戻すのだ。
翌年、私たちは結婚
し、Oh wow, Grisha had multiple families.
名はジーク。
No!
世の中が急速に発展していく頃、エルディア復権派は転機を迎える。
So Aaron knows this. He's seen this picture. He had the book, although he couldn't read it. Woo! Quite a twist. Zeke grew up to be a real jerk. Something went wrong. If Zeke, son of Grisha, an Eldian, is attacking the Eldians. This is a very obvious danger to this whole thing, speaking of not becoming the evil that you hate. This is probably going to be controversial, but a lot of the things they're doing is just the flip side of what is being done to them, right? Like the mythology of their race. Is that really true? I don't know. I guess it's possible, but I doubt it. I doubt it in the show. There's going to be spin on both sides. Then the goal, right? The goal is to win, to defeat the enemy. To destroy the Marleyans or whatever they're called. It ends up being the same world. And so if you're complaining that the world is cruel, well, there it is, right? Like that's what continues it. Because then you have a Marleyan kid whose sister gets torn apart by dogs. That's probably how that ends. So even though the way it's framed, we're on Grisha's side, of course, it's not the highest answer. It's not the heroic answer. At least that's my feeling right now, having seen what I've seen so far.
Mare 政府が動き出した理由は、軍事技術の発展による資源争奪の時代に、いち早く対応するためらしい。決して無視できるものではなくなった。
ファーストフィオーさ。
手段は残されている。我々の息子ジークを。
I'm sure this would be great.
マーレの戦士にするのだ。
Okay.
マーレの人間が言っていることは全て間違っ
ている。No pressure, Zeke.
だがお前は誰よりもマーレの教えに従順に従わなければならない。
Speaking of fathers placing their whole lives' wishes into their kids.
わかった。
All Zeke wanted to do was play baseball.
Yes, that's what I
was saying. Endeavor, anyone? I was just talking about this in My Hero Academia, like this exact thing. Zeke ratted on him? Yeah, you can probably feel that he didn't have any regard for him as his own person. Humanity outside the walls. Though the humans who live outside the walls look no different than us and speak the same language as we do, their civilization appears far more advanced than ours. However, they view us who live inside the walls as a race of devils that have committed terrible sins. That's what the wall is. Perimeter of the island. I would like to know that as well. Who is the owl? We probably know him. They didn't even inject him. Gonna make a move before you go out. I feel like I've seen that guy as a Titan before. Beard guy. It's not so bad. Just go with it. This guy, on the other hand. They don't care. Have we seen her before? She looks kind of familiar. Did she eat Eren's mom? Oh no! Oh no! Oh no. He knows all this, of course. What? Nice bed hair. There's just so much going on right now. Are they serving insubordination because of the injection thing? Boy, they really didn't let that go, did they? But yeah, that's a lot to take in. Am I right? Am I correct that it was Grisha's wife, Dina, that ate Grisha's wife, Carla? Is that how that went? Some weird symbolism there. And now Grisha's kid, Zeke, is trying to kill Grisha's kid, Eren. Or at least eat them. It's all coming together. This does answer a whole lot of questions. I feel like it's going to take me a while to catch up with all the details, but I think it's clearer than it's ever been, safe to say. But is it still about resources? That can't be it. That can't be all it is. Memories. Finally. Yeah, it was her. Yikes. Yep, but he's gonna survive, obviously. Because they're just sick people in a sick world. The world is cruel. Yeah, I mean, these people exist. It's just that they're held at bay by, like, people who are better than them, usually. This guy's concocted a whole world around his worst qualities. I mean, his people would have ended up doing the same thing this guy's doing, seems to me. But that doesn't make him less evil. Whoa. Is this the owl? He was holding him back for a reason. This one looks familiar too, I just can't remember where I've seen it. He is the owl. Wait, which Titan is he? Is that... Wait, what? I'm confused. Next episode time! He looked an awful lot like Eren in Titan form. Does that mean Grisha eats the owl? I'm trying to keep it straight. Eren's core Titan is actually not the coordinate Titan. He was a different Titan. He only has the coordinate Titan powers because Grisha, in I guess this Titan form it seems, ate the coordinate Titan and then Eren ate him. Anyway, Titan lineage aside, this is probably the biggest reveal ever in the show's history. We actually got sides. We actually know who's attacking, I think. Since the Restoration Project seems to have been wiped out, the so-called warriors are the, what are they called? The Marleyans. But I'm skeptical that it's still just about resources. In fact, I'm skeptical of a lot of the stories we're getting because both parties have their interest in spinning the story for their own selfish interests, for power, for control, or whatever. I think it's safe to say the truth is somewhere in the middle. Like, there probably was this original person, Ymir, who met the, you know, some kind of power, Earth Devil power or something. Whether or not her actions were good is unclear, but that seems to have been the origin one way or the other, and then it's been a matter of like vying for control. And the stories people use are one of the tools they use, one of the non-Titan tools they use. Just as Rob Reiss controls narrative through actual Titan powers to further his own agenda. One interesting thing that keeps coming to mind is that the Marleyans saw the king inside the walls as a threat, that he would be the one to unleash the Titan powers, which is interesting. Maybe it's that threat that they seek to destroy. I mean, probably is that threat they seek to destroy. They probably see it as a threat to the Marley civilization. But who really knows the truth? We're like back to a new level of unknown truth. Now we have names and faces, but we still don't know exactly what's going on. But I think one thing is clear, that there's no good side or bad side in this, probably. It just comes down to the people, the individuals. Like for me, Erwin... Erwin is dead, but my fanboying continues. Was a good person, independent of sides, just because he did what he felt was right, and he didn't use lies. In fact, he was trying to uncover lies for the sake of others. Add to that the fact that everything he did was in self-defense, the fact that he wasn't genocidal, etc., make him a pretty solid person. Hanji, I'd put in that category as well, not to fanboy on Erwin too hard. Levi definitely getting there, you know, like making the right choices, following something like a conscience. That, for me, sets them apart from the sides they're on. And I think that is the answer. You know, that's the solution to this problem of like a cruel world where everyone's warring and everyone's sort of doing the same evil to win and justifying those evil deeds as like, well, they started it, you know, or I deserve to live freely. That statement is valid, but that doesn't make all tools towards that end valid. Very interesting episode. I'm guessing we're not done. I mean, I'm guessing this is the beginning of Grisha, the Grisha journey, although we know he ends up inside the walls. But there's still a lot to uncover, I feel. So very much looking forward to, I think, the last two episodes in this season. What a crazy season it's been. It's unreal.